Hello, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com, and today I'm talking with you about how different memories and viewpoints are to be expected in the quantum age. So, what do I mean by that? What I mean is that facts, when you look at quantum logic, which is very different than Boolean classical logic, it's very much a different situation than the kind of facts and truth that we think we're used to. We tend to think in terms of classical logic because ever since the Boolean logic came into being in the West, we embraced it as the wonderful way to solve problems, to be able to sort through various issues and get to some technological advancements that we probably wouldn't have achieved as quickly as we did without it. So this quantum logic is now being investigated and developed in relation to quantum computing and the new quantum age. And what it does is it embraces a much more, let's say, ever-changing nature of reality, shall we put it that way. So what you might think of as facts are much more like networks and relationships between various pieces of information and components. So depending on who you are as the observer and who you think you are, and based on your level of awareness and the way that you're observing the entire system, you'll actually get different kinds of information at different times. And you may have noticed this in your personal life if you talk with family members about things that you know for sure happened in your childhood, and you're shocked to find out that a sibling or a best friend remembers things very differently. And there's been a photo going around the internet recently which tends to illustrate this beautifully, so I'm going to hold it up for you. You can see it's got an object here with these images. This is true, and this is true, and this is truth. And so based on the way that the object is perceived, based on the light that's cast on it, you see a different shape, you see a different color. And there are different variations of that image, sometimes with three different shapes and three different colors. And there can be a lot more than that in terms of ways to remember a particular event. This is a topic I've covered in the book Quantum Jumps, An Extraordinary Science of Happiness and Prosperity, when I talk about flashbulb memories and the way that in some cases people have been scientifically documented as writing down in their own handwriting what happened and where they were and what they were doing when they heard the news, for example, of the Challenger space shuttle explosion. And then, these are college students, just a few short years later, they're asked again to write down answers to the same questions they were asked the very day after the incident had occurred. And these very same students would sometimes remember things the same, which is not that surprising. Other times, they would remember things very differently, to the point that they were shocked to see their own handwriting and would say things like, "This is my handwriting, and these are my words, but that's not the way it happened." And if you have experienced reality shifts, then you know that feeling. You know it quite well. If you've gone through quantum jumps and you've seen things move around almost by themselves, then you're familiar with it. And so what I'd like you to do is start thinking about how can you experience more abundance, more of a sense of meaning and purpose in your life when you know that facts are pretty malleable. They're not always locked in place. What can stay the same is the relationship of our understanding, and as we play with levels of conscious awareness through meditation, lucid dreaming, and other things like that. Some people have near-death experiences, that counts too. These people definitely start experiencing a lot more of these shifts in reality and quantum jumps. So I hope you think about how that can benefit you in your life. And until next time, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com. Thanks.